As we depart the Nairobi train station, everybody take a look over on the right-hand side of the train there. Makita, our hard-working station master. Everybody put you on the air, wave it like a fist on parents. Say, bye, Makita. Come on, show her a little loving, guys. Bye, Makita. Hey, we'll be back here to see Makita in about 35 to 40 minutes. Over on the right-hand side of the train, you see a big tank of water. That's the home of our African penguins. These are warm water penguins, folks, and very friendly. Don't be surprised if you walk by the tank, actually follow you around the tank. On both sides of the train, you can see a roller coaster called Cheetah. You see there is a magnetic launch coaster. The launch is from 0 to 60 in about 3 seconds. Much like the acceleration of a real Cheetah. That only takes you upside down one time. I guess that loop is kind of a barrel roll. The coaster still spend more air time than seat time on Cheetah. Over on the left-hand side of the train, you'll see a bunch of bushes. Just beyond those bushes at the edge of Africa. 16-acre self-directed walking tour. You could now see the African lions, the hyenas, meerkats, hippopotamus, and Nile crocodile. That beautiful building you see up on the hill on the right, close there, and then you overlook Rekha and Pura. Great place to get four tables, service dining on the top floor. You can grab a piece of pizza on the bottom floor, sit out on the veranda, and watch animals play. For those of you over 21, it's got a full service bar. And for such a hot day like today, it's air conditioned. Corbett's Church is a family-style street coaster. We take you up the first of its kind outdoor elevator, set 15 up in the air, launching forward to face the face with the King Cobra. First third of the ride, you go forward. Second third, you go backwards. Final third of the ride, you get three spinners, and then you follow the waitress to the front of your car. Once again, this is a family-style street coaster. Only goes upside down 0 times and 45 miles per hour.
Thank you.
Smallest of all the zebra species, it is the only species of zebra where the stripes go all the way down the belly. This is also the most photographed zebra species. If you ever see a picture of a zebra in a magazine, you notice the stripes go all the way around the belly. Rest assured, all your good friends tell me that's a grand zebra. Up in the distance over on the left, you'll probably get a better view of them as we go around the bend. Great shaggy looking animals underneath that tree over there are the wildebeest, also known as the white bearded gnu. These animals travel in very large herds during their migration, often up to a million strong. Baby wildebeest must be up and running with his herd within 3 to 7 minutes after being born, or they will get left behind. Please stay seated, take all the pictures you like from your seated position. Thank you. Once a baby gets left behind, left to fend for itself. And once that baby loses its mama in the Serengeti, there's no other mama's gonna take care of that baby. It's off the fend for itself and certain doom. The brown and white striped animals you see over there is Grant Grizel. Grant Grizel is a little bit larger than the Thompson Grizel that we saw back in the Antelope Creek extension. And instead of having a black wagging tail, they had a white square on the backside. Those of you on the left-hand side of the train, jump down a couple of rocks to see some ostrich eggs. Ostrich eggs, we left off some of our ostriches. Ostrich is the second, the largest of all the bird species. They grow about 9 feet tall and weigh about 330 pounds. Because of their great size, they are completely flightless. The gray, shaggy animals you see with a white circle on their backside is called a waterbuck animal. Waterbuck animals, that they have named their eyes, must live very near the water. Many of our animal species can adapt their body temperatures to survive the hot desert conditions in the Serengeti. These animals cannot. They must live near the water. Going into a tunnel over here, so if any of you are with your significant other or that left of your life, it's okay to reach over and get a little peck on the cheek. But remember, I'm trapped for watching, so keep it at a peck on the cheek only. Talk to the people who take care of our animals here at Busch Gardens. See, if you match a specific animal, what would you be interested in? We're entering into the Congo train station. This is supposed to stop two of the Kumba roller coaster. The Congo River Rapids, the Shangala section of our park, where you go see the endangered orangutan, Bengal Malayan tigers, and the Banjo Theater, currently showing a musical comedy called Okay Night Critters, featuring some of the rescued domestic and wild animals we have at this park. As we come into the Congo train station, please remember to remain seated until the train comes to a full stop. Once the train comes to a full complete stop, I'll tell you when to say thank you on the platform side only. Thank you for joining us. Our next stop will be Stanleyville.